Hello students of Standard 10. Welcome to this YouTube channel of Monbrecia. I am here with your same chapter in your political science, federalism. We are with a new topic, that is decentralization in India. We all know that federal government have more than two tiers of governments. We have so far discussed two tiers of government, central government and state government. But a vast country like India cannot be run only through these two tiers. States in India are so large that they are larger than the independent countries of Europe. For example, Uttar Pradesh is bigger than Russia. Maharashtra is about as big as Germany. Many of these states are internally very diverse. Diverse means divided. Many of these states of our country. There is thus a need for power sharing within these states. Some states are very large, so some power should be shared from state to different level, because the state government cannot go nooks and corners of the state to look after the problems of the common people. Federal power sharing in India needs another tier of government for this, to see the problems of, as I have told you, nooks and corners of these big states. Federal power sharing in the state is now built. Required. This is the rationale for decentralization of power. That is called decentralization. First, it has been decentralized from center to states. Power has been distributed from center to the different states. Now, the power has been divided, the state power has been divided into small units inside the states. Thus, it resulted in a three tier of government called local government. And this third tier of government is called local government. When power is taken away from central and state government and given to local government, it is called decentralization. Power is taken away from not only central and state. These are the powerful unit, and when their power is distributed among the smaller units inside a state are called decentralization. The basic idea behind decentralization is that there is a large number of problems and issues which are best settled at the local level. People have better knowledge and ideas on where to spend money and how to manage these more efficiently. Which work is more needed in a particular area? It is the local people who will know about it, not a particular state. Besides, at the local level, it is possible for the people to directly participate, for the people in the decision making. This helps to inculcate a habit of democratic participation. Local government is the best way to realize one important principle of democracy, namely local self-government. Panchayats in villages and municipalities in urban areas were set up in all states to look after the problems of every persons in every nooks and corners of the state. Elections were not held regularly whenever it is required. Local government did not have any power of resources. It is the state government which distribute the money to different municipalities and village panchayats to run the process, to run the government in the lower units smoothly. The major steps towards decentralization was taken in 1992. The constitution was amended to make the three tier of democracy more powerful and effective. What are the different steps taken by the constitution to run the local self-government smoothly? We will discuss in my next video. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.